And see, I'm sure you must have read whatever I gave. I think we have given a press note as well. So if there are any additional questions which you may want to ask, you know, I am ready to answer them. But my only one humble and sincere request is, I will not be able to do one-on-one interviews. Please. Because then it becomes very difficult, because I might say something here and say something, because then it becomes very contradictory. So please excuse me. Maybe another time I will definitely do for everybody. But since today is a very, very important meeting, you know, because I don't want to say one thing to one channel and one thing to one thing. So it will be like a uniform thing. So, well, I have already sent my this thing to the ombudsman, so he will look into it, and then whatever he decides, you know, it will be final and binding. No, they have no right. Naturally, I am controlling the association. They are not controlling the association because they are all tainted, and they have been inquired upon by the ombudsman. They have been given notices for having multiple clubs before also, and I mean they have been charged by the ACB also, and then they are awaiting the cases which is happening now, and they have on moral grounds actually they should resign for having all these things, you know, what they have done. So what they are doing is totally illegal, because they cannot do anything without the president. The president has to be there without my concurrence. They cannot do anything. They cannot hold meetings, because you cannot just hold meetings, five of them, and then they say, okay, no, we are majority. But even in a majority, you have to do the right things. Because what is a, in hurry, there was no need for any meetings, you know, when I have already written to them two times, and still they are going on and doing all these things. So I think it is totally illegal, and I think they have no right to, I mean, actually ban me or show cause, I mean, notice me, because I am elected by the general body. The Apex Council has no right to suspend or ban anybody. I mean, the only thing is that, you know, I mean, I have already, I mean, like on the like there are so many clubs, you know, who have complained to me about their activities, about the case I mean which was filed by the Charminar Cricket Club against these budding stars and the association, which I think the secretary has colluded, which is already clearly written in the judgment. If you want me to really read the judgment also, I can read the last, I'm sure, last four the opinions of the High Court, which says, because I want to reiterate, because you must all know, you know, because since you are here, yeah, if you see the judgment, the opinion of the court is, the filing of the OP itself is an abuse of process of court. There is a clear collusion between one first respondent and Vijayanand, secretary of the second respondent. Yeah, and both of them did not come to the court with clean hands and suppress true facts. And then it goes on to say that the respondent numbers 1 and 2 wanted to delay the appointment of the ombudsman and ethics officer and to embarrass Justice Deepak Verma, former judge of the Supreme Court. So the PSROP number 17 of 2020 itself is dismissed, as its continuance might lead to commission of further fraud and mischief by the first respondent and R. Vijayanand, the secretary of the second respondent, and others supporting them. The others supporting them are the other four people. There's John Manoj, Narendra Sharma, Surinda Garwal, and Anuradha. So this is the order which is given by the Honorable High Court. On this order only, and they have been fined also, both the budding star and the other, and Vijayan has been fined 25,000 rupees, fine, and they have to pay in the court. And then also it is very clear that the, I mean, about the Apex Council thing, you know everything about the ombudsman thing. Because, yeah, because the court has also said that it is therefore clear that Sri Vijayanand, secretary of the second respondent, having agreed to a particular decision in the Apex Council meeting, held on 6/11/2020 in the presence of all members of the Apex Council, clandestinely arranged another meeting on the same day with himself, Sundar Kumar, the Treasurer, John Manoj, the President, Naresh Sharma, Joint Secretary, and Councillor Anuradha behind the back of the President Mohammad Azharuddin, and got order passed and got passed another resolution and passed it off as the Apex Council meeting resolution, and deliberately misled the court below to help the first respondent get the impugned interim order. It is much clearer, everything much clearer than that. Who is doing what, everybody knows. I am here to clear everything, whatever happened. See, I want to ask everybody who is sitting here, why for the last 25 years only these people are holding positions in the association? Why can't the other secretaries hold the positions as well? Because they need to, for the last 25 years, they do all those blackmailing tactics, which I am not going to cow down to those things, because I have played cricket at the highest level, I have played with a lot of dignity, I have done everything for the best for the country, and I am not going to cow down to this blackmailing tactics, which I think has been happening for the last 20-25 years. Because why only these people are only in the committees? Why not others? There are others also who are there, who are deserving. But then this blackmailing tactics has to end, because if it doesn't happen now, it will never happen, Hyderabad cricket will never improve. For the last 25 to 30 years, this has been happening. And I really want to do something for the game of cricket. What am I, every day somebody says about me that I've been banned and do whatever, suspended. Why am I taking all this? I'm only taking it because I love the game, I love the cricket, I love cricket of Hyderabad. Because I've been brought up here, I've played on this ground many times and I've done so much. It pains me to see that, these things are not happening properly. And what about these people are talking about cricket? What have they played cricket? Please tell me. I want to ask anybody. If anybody has played, even a little bit of cricket, what cricket they are talking about? I know what the cricket they are talking about.